Good evening, gentlemen. Wanted to thank you for having me here this evening. My name is Keith Kidwell. I am the chairman of the Beaufort County Republican Party. Reason I'm here tonight is on the issue of the jail. Something I've heard from a lot of people in Beaufort County, the Beaufort County voters. I see a lot of folks over at my office, and obviously they're always concerned about taxes and spending and the government, that sort of thing. So one of the things that the public has voiced their opinion is the needing of transparency and fiscal responsibility for the people of Beaufort County on the issues surrounding the jail. Personally, I do not have an opinion one way or the other on whether or not we need to build a new jail or what needs to happen with it. What I do have are questions that I've tried to put together from the people I've spoken with in the county. One of the most recent things, I understand there's a Superior Court judge's order about the building of a jail. I was wondering if anybody had asked the State Attorney General if that judge has the authority to dictate the expenditure of public money. It is my understanding that the legislature, or this commission as it would have that authority, not a judge.
Can I comment on that?
Certainly.
If you go to the North Carolina School of Government website, basically if you look at all the responsibilities on that, in that website, it does not list that the judge has the responsibility to either close the jail, and it does not list the responsibility of ordering a jail.
Right.
In relation to closing the jail, it would be up to the secretary of the Department of Health and Human Services can order it. The role of the judge, according to the school government, is that the judge can hear any appeals in relation to the Department of Health and Human Services decision, is what I know in relation to.
I understand. According to the Constitution, the North Carolina Constitution, Article 5, Section 4, mm-hmm. very specifically lays out that the legislative body, being this commission, retains the right on expenditures. The judge can order a jail closed in the event it does not meet the state minimums, which right now our jail is open, indicating it does meet the state minimums, because otherwise it would not be open. Okay? The other thing that I've heard many questions on, has a study been done by an independent firm that does not have a profit motive involved in the potential of building, renovating, doing whatever we're going to do with the jail? To my understanding, the answer to that is no, according to Mr. Woodruff, who I spoke with last week on this very issue. Okay? I've been in business a long time. Studied business in college. That's what I majored. I studies on what, why, who, when, where, that all has to be done before you spend money. Okay? And it would always be an independent. It would not be somebody who has a profit motive involved in this project. And to my understanding, that is exactly where we are with Mosley. Okay, that they stand to profit from the building of a jail. That's putting the fox in charge of the hen house. And I don't think that's what the people of Beaufort County expect. They expect that we have a fair, open bid. If, in fact, it does come back that a study is done that we need a jail. It just makes sense to me to maybe spend $50,000, $60,000, whatever it takes, before we spend $20-plus million. Okay? Are there any other options available? Can we do something other than building? Can we renovate? Now, I know this has been fought back and forth a couple of times. We don't have a study that shows that. That study can be all-encompassing and show us everything we need to know about the aspects of a jail. There are companies, there are people out there. There's probably, you could get somebody from ECU to help on that, to come in and say, hey, let's take a look at what we actually need. There's many things that can be done other than that. We can farm out prisoners to another county. We can slap an ankle bracelet on the nonviolent offenders and send them home to lighten the burden on the county jail. We could try people faster. I look at some of the records of our county jail. Our county jail sometimes holds people for trial for 3 years, I've seen it. What happens to these people's right to a speedy trial? How does our district attorney allow someone to sit in a jail for 3 years and not try them? It's amazing to me. That would lighten the burden on the jail and possibly reduce, A, do we need one, and B, if we do, can we build smaller? Okay? By moving the prisoners through more quickly. If we need a new jail, this study should reflect what the need is. Some of the research that I've seen that was done, first one I believe dated, indicated 350 beds. We house 100 to 120 at this time. Why on earth would we need 350 beds?
The study didn't recommend 350 beds. It recommended a 350-person core.
Right. According to what I saw at Mr. Woodruff's office, it was about 350 beds, give or take a few. And, that was the first proposal that came back from Mosley.
And the beds specified, I believe, was 280 beds. And 80 of those beds were originally specified to be put in there, and Mosley put them in relation to housing federal prisoners to bring revenue in. The needs of the jail without the...
Do we have a study, Mr. Clem, that would indicate that the federal government is willing, ready, and able to place prisoners here and that it would be a profitable endeavor?
No. All we got is word of mouth by other prisons.
Okay.
That's all we have.
Well, you know, I would again go back to this is why the research and the homework should be done before we spend $20 million of taxpayers' money. Okay? To me, it would make sense to do that in advance. I'm not going to go out. This is not the field of dreams. If you build it, they will come. By God, I'm a taxpayer. I don't want you spending my money on a field of dreams. I want to spend it on facts and figures and things that we absolutely have to have here in Beaufort County. I want to keep within my time limit. The point being, whether we first initially thought it was 350, 280, now we're at 176. That it just seems kind of random, okay? Do we have justification even for the 176? Right now we're housing 105 roughly prisoners on average. 176 would be a huge percentile of increase. I don't think Beaufort County is going to grow that much in the next 30 years. Hasn't grown that much in the last 30. I don't think it's going to change much. Again, what do we need? Let's get a professional to say, you need 176. Fine. Like I said, I have no opinion either way. I just ask for transparency and fiscal responsibility. Make sure we're doing what needs to be done. What is the economic impact on the location? If we build it here, if we build it in Chocowinity, what does it do to the economy of Beaufort County? In effect, if you move the jail, is it possible? I know the Sheriff's Department would go with it. It would be a logical step that at some point, and I believe some member of this committee or of this commission has indicated it would be the natural progression, to then move the courthouse. If that were to happen, what happens to the economy of downtown Washington, where the lawyers and their clients go to eat lunch and do their shopping and do their Christmas shopping? That's going to move out of downtown Washington. You might as well take a gun and put it to the head of these people that are currently treading water.
Ordinarily, I just sit here and continue to listen to you, but let me say this, that the county courthouse always has to be into the incorporated city limits of the county seat.
That's wonderful. I'm glad to hear that's not what I understood that a particular commissioner had said, that it would do that. But
that's wrong.
If we lose that courthouse here in Washington, the game's over for the economy of Washington itself, and particularly the downtown area.
The legislature can make that change on petition. That's not an accurate statement.
Okay. All right. Don't eat up my time, guys. All right. The other point would be, do we really want to increase taxes on the Beaufort County taxpayer at this point in time? Is that fiscally responsible? Is that responsible to your constituency to turn around? And I want you to think about this, guys. We are absolutely in the worst recession of probably anyone in this room's lifetime. I know of no business, well, some of the repair businesses are doing better, but virtually every other business is doing horribly. People aren't making money. There are people out of work. We have lost business out of this county like a stuck pig. It's not going to change in the near future under the current economic conditions. As well as being in the worst recession of our times, our property taxes have already gone up astronomically. Most of us experienced a double in our homeowners' insurance policies in the last few years. And I hate to tell you, folks, this is something I know very well from my business. You're about to get killed with health insurance expense. Has anybody gotten their new Obama rates? I'm sorry, the Affordable Care Act rates? I have clients coming in and showing me these things saying, Keith, how do I afford this? One guy went from $207 a month to $751. Another one went from $500 and some to over $1,500. Do we want to raise Beaufort County people's taxes at this time? I think that would be totally fiscally irresponsible to the people of Beaufort County.
Keith.
Sir.
You missed one.
What did I miss?
Flood insurance.
Well, you're right. I'm sorry. And wind insurance.
Well, flood insurance, national flood insurance, in some areas down in Louisiana has gone up and hit the $20,000 mark. And
well,
it's being fought in court right now.
And I understand.
Based on the elevation.
What's going to happen here?
$6,700 in some areas, possibly.
Now, all I can tell you, and thank you for making my point, it's a bad time to raise taxes. We don't have work. We don't have new jobs coming into the area. Our taxes have already increased. Our insurances are increasing. You know, how do the people afford to pay for this particular project? So here, again, not whether we build or not, whether the timing is accurate. Maybe we need to say, okay, we do need to do this. Study comes back and says we do. We should look at the timing issue at that point. When is the best time?
We do have new jobs coming into Beaufort County, by the way.
Al, I'm going to bet you're not replacing what's been lost in this county since 1997. We have lost a net of over 3,000 jobs.
No, that's not true. Since the beginning of 1990, Beaufort County has lost a total of 5,100 manufacturing jobs.
Okay. Thank you for making my point even better. Okay?
That's just manufacturing jobs. That's not.
That's just manufacturing, because for every job you lose, you're affecting some other business, and that is my point exactly. We're not in an economic situation here in Beaufort County to go spend money that could possibly, if we do have to do it, again, fine. Let's look at the timing issue of it, just as I would do in my business. There's many things I'd like to do in my business. I'd like to be able to put in newer, better furniture. I have to wait for the economy to recover before I can do that. I need a new copier. I can't spend that until I make the profit to do it. And this county is a business, in fact. And that's something we need to take into consideration. What other options are out there? We talked about that a little bit. There's many other ways to approach this problem, even if it were just a temporary basis. Put it off for a little while, 3 years, 5 years, let's see when things start to pick up, and maybe at that point we can say, hey, let's build the jail. Why is this not being put to a referendum? We did it with the county school bonds. We wanted to spend $30 million. We put it out to the voters and asked them. They are the impacted people. They're the ones that foot the bill, gentlemen. I think they should have a dog in the race. I've worked on many different committees. Always what happens is you establish a committee that is comprised of stakeholders. To my understanding at this point, for the vast majority of the people that have been on the committees to do with the jail, it has been members of this commission. To me, it would seem much more effective. You would get much better participation from the people in Beaufort County if we had a stakeholder committee that consisted of the county commissioners, obviously, representatives possibly from each city council in the cities, because they will be affected as well, and then some people at large from Beaufort County, wise business owners. Let's represent the poor orphaned part of this county up in the northeast section, where they're just basically ignored by everybody from the Chamber of Commerce and everything else that goes on. These people need to know how their taxes are being spent and need to have input into it. Again, I'm not here to speak for or against the building of a jail. I am here as a concerned Beaufort County taxpayer, as well as the representative of the Beaufort County Republican Party as chairman. What I'm endeavoring to do, Mr. Commissioners, is to ask that we follow what is standard business practices and fiscal responsibility. In business, we don't just think we need to do something. We research it, we justify it, and then we take action. This action is always based on well-grounded facts and figures. I've been responsible for a lot of building projects in my lifetime. As a manager for several Fortune 500 companies, I've built office buildings and warehouses. I've added on and renovated my building here in Beaufort County, my office building. I've sat on search committees and building committees of many churches and nonprofits. And I can tell you the practice has always been the same. Establish a committee of concerned and impacted stakeholders. Do the study, do the research, justify the expenditure, and then take action. That's what the people of Beaufort County are entitled to. The other thing I'd like to point out, since I do still have a couple minutes left on my time, quickly went through this thing. I'm going to do a little bit more digging on it. This is the Mosley proposal. I do want to point out a couple of issues here. If I go to attachment D, at the bottom we have a subtotal that's 4.8, and if I'm doing my math correctly, 4.8 and 4.8 for the intake and the booking officers does not equal 4.8. It equals 9.6. They have a definite mathematical error there, which I'll continue with. As we come down into the verbiage underneath of that, about halfway down, it says Beaufort County is going from 86 bed capacity to 176 facility, only increasing the staff by 32, which is 10 less than double, but increasing the bed count by double. I'm not Einstein, but according to this report, we currently employ 21 people at the jail. The projected need would go to 53. That is not 10 less than half. That's 11 more than double. I might also add, when you correct the math in their addition, it's not 53 total people. It's 57.4, okay? Back on the page behind attachment E at the bottom, it's indicating a study that was done to drive to and from, if they put a location at Chocowinity, to the courthouse. Their quotation there, first of all, is inaccurate. They have 56 cents per mile as the IRS standard. It's actually 56 and a half, but let's not split hairs. But let's go with this. That IRS standard is for passenger cars. I venture to guess there's not a police car out there that you can operate for the IRS standard. They're far more expensive. They have bigger motors, bigger brakes, bigger tires. Everything about them is more expensive, okay? The second thing would be is I sincerely doubt you would be transporting prisoners in a police car. You would more likely use a van. So your expense in that will be absolutely out of whack, okay? The reason I bring up those 2 points is not for those menial entries. I have to consider Mosley. If you take a look at these numbers, gentlemen, we added one and one and one and two, and the biggest number we're adding is 12, and we can't do that. How can we trust them to add up what comes up to $19 million? I ask you, gentlemen, one more time, research, justify, and be fiscally responsible and open to the people of Beaufort County. Thank you very much for the time this evening.
Thank you.